A budget is in the constitution, it is called an annual financial statement. There is no word called the budget in the constitution. It has incomes on the left and expenditure on the right. Here there was no left and there was no right. There was no mention of any figure anywhere. So therefore, to call this a budget speech itself is a problem. It was a speech, definitely.
Vision for the decade. Our economy was at approximately $1.85 trillion US dollars when we formed the government in 2014. Within 5 years, it has reached $2.7 trillion US dollars. Hence, it is well within our capacity to reach the $5 trillion US dollars in the next few years.
This budget has a revenue income of about 19 lakh crores and it will spend about 24 lakh crores. But when we go back and look at the economic survey, then we find that that figure that the finance minister is saying, which is 19.5 lakh crores, is nowhere in the economic survey. The closest figure of revenue mobilization is 18 lakh crores. That means that we are talking about a shortfall of 1.5 lakh crores. When you fudge national data, one is that you can fudge and report it, but how do you then spend that money? How do you then give money to the people you have promised money? There was one new ministry carved out of the Ministry of Agriculture, and that is the Ministry of Dairying and Animal Husbandry. A very state subject, to a lot of us, one of the very minor issues in what the country is supposed to be worried about, but a big central ministry now. The budget announced a new ministry, and that was the Jal Shakti Ministry, another state subject.
Har Ghar Jal, to all rural households by 2024 under the Jal Jeevan Mission.
First 15 minutes of the budget spent entirely on the third state subject, which was a long speech on the farmers. So she said that the solution to agriculture, this whole problem that we have been grappling with for 70 years, the solution is zero budget natural farming. The definition of zero budget natural farming is stop using fertilizers, stop using pesticide, start using cow urine mixed with jaggery. That is the solution to all farming problems in the country.
We need to replicate this innovative model through which in a few states, farmers are already being trained in this practice. Steps such as this can help in doubling our farmers' income in time for our 75th year of independence. This country's tradition has been Nari to Narayani. This government wishes to encourage and facilitate the role of women.
All of us, edge of our streets, seats waiting to have this huge outlay on women. And there it comes. What does she give for gender empowerment in the country? What she says is that for every woman who is a member of a self-help group and has a Jandhan account, we will give each one of them a 5,000 rupee loan.
For every verified woman SHG member having a Jandhan account, an overdraft of 5,000 shall be allowed. The fiscal deficit this year is 3.3%, brought down from 3.4%.
You keep fiscal deficit in check, prices will remain in check. The negative consequence of keeping price low is that farm prices stay low. For the last 5 years, farmers, the number of suicides you saw, the distress you saw, was in a large extent because of keeping farm prices artificially very low. There is a very simple economic principle which says that if you keep prices low, you will generate larger unemployment. Why would a political party want to increase unemployment in society? Deliberately keep inflation low and therefore ensure that jobs disappear. My hypothesis there is that the only reason to do that is because this country doesn't care about jobs. In India, if you want to be politically successful and you're looking at only the economic issues, then unemployment does not matter, right? Growth does not matter. Manufacturing does not matter. Unorganized sector does not matter. Agriculture does not matter. The only thing that matters is prices. You keep prices low, you will win the election. You let prices go high, you will lose the next election. We have hugely overestimated our GST collection. When this magic GST was unleashed, we said that every month we will earn 1 lakh crore rupees on GST. Not a single month did we earn 1 lakh crores. We were short of, by about 10,000-12,000 crores of GST. You know, the reason this wasn't talked about was because a slowdown in GST collections, one, shows that this dream reform wasn't successful. Secondly, that industry is not producing enough because that is how GST gets generated. And third, that it is resulting in job losses.
Those in the highest income brackets need to contribute more to the nation's development. I therefore propose to enhance the surcharge on individuals having taxable income from 2 crore to 5 crores and 5 crore and above, so that effective tax rates for these two categories will increase by around 3% and 7% respectively.
It is not a 3% of extra tax, it's a 3% surcharge. So you're adding something like 0.2% and 7% surcharge to those who earn more than 5 crores. I did my calculations based on the number of people we have who declared 2 crores and 5 crores. I got a total figure of something like 145 crores. That is what we will earn if we charge this and have this huge mechanism that will go after them. When I looked at the budget papers, the number is 12,000 crores. I mean, how on earth are we going to get 12,000 crores out of some 30,000 fellows who declare their income above 5 crore? This idea that we had thought we had forgotten in the 80s, you know, import duties were increased. It hasn't happened in 25 years, at least I don't remember. Import duties went up. And import duties go up on what? The first import duty that she announces, which really, you know, got me speechless, was an import duty on books. I mean, import duty on books, which country would have that? So there is an import duty on books now.
To encourage domestic publishing and printing industry, 5% customs duty is being imposed on imported books. It is also proposed to increase custom duty on gold and other precious metals from 10 to 12.5%.
You know, one of the first things that Manmohan Singh as finance minister had done was to reduce import duty on gold to 2%. With that one move, one entire sector just disappeared from the economy. And that was the gold smuggler. I remember the gold smuggler of Amar Akbar Anthony and Zanjeer, and that whole sector got wiped out. Good news for them, they are back in business. At 12.5%, it makes great sense to get back to gold smuggling.
Thank you.